Welcome to Transformation Hour with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensa, President of Full Gospel Church International, FGCI Ghana. Full Gospel Church is a Bible-believing church that's committed to helping people discover, develop, and use their gifts, talents, and abilities to enable them become useful and relevant to society, their communities, and to fulfill their life's mission on earth. At FGCI, we achieve this by helping people discover purpose to live for, people to share fellowship with, profession to live out, principles to live by, and power to live on.
Until you have a dream, no one will attack you. Until you know where you are going, no one will fight you.
We believe that anointed and pragmatic teaching is the catalyst for transformation in the lives of individuals and in the church. Hence our message, transforming lives on purpose.
Some complain about the problem. Others will find people to blame about the problem. Only few, the 20%, will fix the problem they encounter.
Full Gospel Church International is a place where we help people reconnect to God. Leaders are raised to be change agents, and talents and gifts are discovered and used.
No matter where you stand, somebody will tag you, but stand for Ghana.
At FGCI, we believe that every member is a minister and that we are saved to save others.
What will connect you to an auto mechanic is only when you have a problem with your vehicle. That is when you now look for an auto mechanic. So you see, problems bring people together in bad times.
We invite you to be our regular guest these and every Sunday on this network as we bring you a systematic and expository teaching of God's Word with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensa.
Don't look at things only from your own perspective. So learn to see things from somebody else's perspective. That is the only way you can appreciate the contributions.
Still stand whilst I read the scriptures. Matthew 26, verse 20 to 35.
Matthew Sampa Etsi Edwenu Siyimu Edwenu Kosi Edwenu Num.
I'm going to just read 20 to 25. 20 to 25. Alright. When it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with the 12. While they were eating, he said, I tell you the truth. One of you will betray me. Greatly distressed, each one asked in turn, Am I the one, Lord? He replied, One of you who has just eaten from this bowl with me will betray me. For the Son of Man must die, as the scriptures declared long ago. But how terrible it will be for the one who betrays him. It would be far better for that man if he had never been born. Judas, the one who would betray him, also asked, "Rabbi, am I the one?" And Jesus told him, "You have said it." May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen.
Please be seated. I am speaking on the subject okukuseku. Onipa hu yehu. Minua eya sro nipa na jaisamai. What that means is that human beings are fearful. Fear human beings more than fear the ghost. It's better to be afraid of a human being than to be afraid of a ghost. In verse 25, we are told in the scriptures, Jesus Christ was saying, in the night he was going to be betrayed, he said, "My heart is disturbed that one of you, the 12 that I have been with you, I have lived with you, I've eaten with you, we played together, we've done everything together, we visited your family, I've been there for you, I stand there for you. One of you, after all that I have done, will betray me." And so naturally, Peter was about the first person. He said, "What? This can't be. Master, is it me?" And so it went on from one to the another. You know, Philip said it. Bartholomew, Andrews, you know. And then everyone was saying, "Master, is it me? Master, is it me?" And then Judas also, who was eating with him, he also said, "Master, is it me?" And Jesus looked at him and said, Judas said, "Rabbi, am I the one?" And Jesus said, "You have said it." Judas was with the 12 disciples for 3 solid years. Judas was the chief accountant. He had traveled with Jesus from Nazareth to Galilee to Bethlehem to Judea to Jordan, you know, to back and forth to Jerusalem. They have done a lot of traveling together. They've slept in hotels. Jesus had visited Judas's family back and forth. They know each other well. Judas had heard so many teachings about Jesus Christ, and most of the teachings that we know of, Judas heard all. Judas witnessed several miracles. As a matter of fact, Judas was there when Jesus told Lazarus, "Arise from the dead." Blind Bartimaeus, when he came to Jesus, Judas was standing there and he watched this miracle. Judas said to himself, "I don't think this guy will forever see because we have known him for many years." But Judas was shocked when Jesus asked the Bartimaeus, "What do you want?" He said, "I will see." And Jesus said, "May your eyes be open and see." Judas was shocked. He has seen several miracles to believe that there is nothing Jesus could not do. What message has Judas never heard? What miracles did he not see? But in spite of all this, he betrayed a friend. If we look at Judas, the characteristics of Judas represent some of the following. A pretender, someone who pretends. He's pretending he likes you, but he hates you. He's pretending to smile with you, but in his heart, he will stab you. A traitor who will always undermine you. A backstabber, someone who will malign you, say negative things in your aspect and your absence. When you are with him, he will praise you. The moment you turn your back, he will say nasty things about
you.
You are with him. He's your friend. You turn your back, he will lie. He will say all kinds of nasty things against you and about you. A friend pastor of mine said they boarded a same flight from, I think, from Amsterdam to Accra. These are ministers of the gospel. Pastor, they said they happened to be in the first class seat, and so one of them was in front, and my friend who was in front, I mean in the first class, later on the air hostess came around and he said, oh, you know, this other guy sitting two seats behind me, he's another friend of mine, he's a pastor, he's a great friend. So that friend told the air hostess that, look, the one three seats behind me is a great friend, he's a good friend. And then the air hostess told him, did you say he's your friend? He said yes. For how long have you known him? He said for many years. He said if you knew what he said about you, you would wonder whether he's your friend. Just 10 minutes when they had gotten into the aircraft. He don't know the air hostess. Yes, you said nasty thing about your friend. That is the spirit of Judas.
Where Judas?
That is the spirit of Judas.
Judas,
he will pretend he likes you. Just cross his path and he will say all kinds of nasty things about you.
The
Bible describes him as a thief.
Bible says
an azaman. A 419 man.
A 419.
I mean, during those days, Judas was an azan person.
Sir, not Judas, azan pa.
A 419, top class.
419, no, a quadri woman pa.
A schemer, someone who will fight the progress of people.
Obia or kutsia and crawfoo ye, dear.
I am sure, whilst I'm describing him, you are having a mental picture of some of the Judases you know. Who will cross you and fight your progress in life? We are talking of a deceiver. We are talking of a conspirator. We are talking of a liar. Interestingly, we find some of these characteristics playing out in our life. So what are some of the key things we can derive from this story about Okukuseku? What are some of the things we can pick up from the life of Judas? Number one, we are our own enemies. We are our own enemies. There is a Ghanaian proverb that says that if an animal wants to bite you, wants to kill you, it comes from your own cloth. Look at a man, when they were having a conversation in verse 23, he replied, one of you who has been eating with me in the same bowl will betray me. And Judas, the one who would betray him, also asked, Rabbi, am I the one? When he knew very well he was the one. When he knew very well he has done the arrangement already. When he knew very well, when he knew very well that everything would just work according to plan, yet he was bold enough to ask, am I the person?
Na Judas e bisane se meka ho ana onya kukudro bisano emra onimu se waye ishishe nyinara na ishishe na waye nyinara no ebefa nanso akukudro mu no obisane se aso meka ho ana.
This attitude is deeply rooted in the Ghanaian society.
Nasa eniyenu etintim ewo Ghana ye yemu.
We enjoy harming people. We enjoy undermining our own. We love to bring people down and damage them. After Sunday service, you go to the market, and then the negative things or anything that has happened in your church, when your pastor's name is mentioned, then the people you who do not even come to your church, you say the negative things about your own pastor. Tomorrow, how do you expect them to come to your church? You tell other people the bad things about your church. You wonder why people will not follow you. They have heard enough about the bad things you said about your own church. They've heard enough of the bad things you said against your own pastor. The pastor who wakes up in the night and pray for you, yet you undermine him, damage him, and say negative things about him to your workmates and to your colleagues. We bewitch each other. We despise our own family members. We fight the progress of people. It appears we love and embrace evil collusions and conspiracy. We love to do evil against people. It seems this is our nature to hear that we love to hear bad news about our friends. We can't rejoice with people when good things happen to them. That is why we love the dead more than the living. When someone is alive and is sick and needs your support, you will never support the person. A family member can help the person pay the hospital bill. He wouldn't do it. Let the person die. They will go and paint the house and refurbish the house. They will spend all the money for funeral when that money could have saved the person when the person was sick. It appears we love to hear bad reports about people. We are talking about the enemy within. And the enemy within is with us. The enemy is in your home and is in your family. The enemy is everywhere. The enemy Judas is with us.
Judas no owo yentem.
We are our own enemies. We are the deadly virus infecting one another. I read an article that talks about a man said, and I will read. The person said, I got the opportunity to meet 6 rich Ghanaian men. And I asked them this question: why are they not building factories for the youth of this country to get a job to do?
Brante bi kan se onya akwanya no kwahia adefo ensie bi e no bi sa won se adent na montimi ensi factory e wo ekremu ama emebu no enye djuma ye.
This six rich businessmen burst into laughter as if I have said something funny. Then one said, the people shouting, no food, no jobs are all thieves.
And about three years and Yamaka no Yasri, and our cousin Crofano, Omutiamu, Omutiamu, a Jubeniwa, a Janiniwa, Omuninaraya Crof.
The writer said, I said, really? I was shocked. And the man then went on, he said, I run a manufacturing business and trading business.
And our cousin, Nami, ye, a Juma, Yankasa, ye, Timmy, ye, maybe I, ye, Timmy, Dija.
He said, the biggest challenge in my manufacturing business is not electricity. It is not infrastructure. The biggest challenge is getting honest staff.
Now, I know cancer on how my power I want me to be in you my phone or Montenegro.
Everyone we hire appears to be on a mission to steal as much as possible. They will inflate invoices, recording less than the actual number of units produced.
Now, omo ama fomo nyinara na omo ba omo pemfaso omo ye nia mebi se ye wanse de pa na omo jo ni tunzi omo ye ma ejuma ni kofo.
The worst part of it all is that all the fraud we have uncovered is not done by single person. It is usually many staff who collude with each other from the production line to sales to finance, and even to top management.
No, can say, Chrono, some are you who too many mono, and your baku for them on a fipe a tikosi, a seno omen, you know, my drink hobby, and chrome and omo boss, a chrono.
The businessman said, there was a year I overhauled management 3 times.
And now, or can say, a fibacono, or your management, or Sisamobe and Prince,
or Sisam management, move 3 times. He changed the top management 3 times in a year. He said, but I have found a solution. I now use Indian expatriate management. So competent, so honest, and so straightforward.
No, cause I feel them many emwaye, many Indian ibi ami oye penyi oyobia odinu kure oye de jumansu ye.
I thought they were expensive at first, with all the visa fees, accommodation, house staff, but now that the losses due to staff theft have been reduced to a minimum and efficiency increased, the Indian management has turned out to be cheaper than the previous African Ghanaian management.
No, because you can say, and can you know, not a yen is send a board day. It's an say, we must say, see, can you yaman yama ubechiano. Now, so I'm a buyer, no mass, son yamanima, omopono, omodiano, ne boy, yadin, to say, Ghana, fauna, or far, omono.
Now, all sensitive positions involving money go to Indians. Africans are only allowed in non-sensitive positions.
No, can say near a disica beny narano echo Indian for her. Now, Africa for their beer and shed and your winner.
This is what the businessman further said. I used to criticize indigenous African companies like Dangote Group that hire so many Indians when there are many unemployed Africans. But now I understand their painful decisions.
And our cancer and canino, a juman cassian cassette is a dango teno, a yamaka omu one sams identina, a be before our quakofa Indian forno, nanso afena, my better one, I say.
He said, my biggest challenge in the trading business is the same. In other words, he has a trading shopping business, and he said, it is getting that is getting honest staff.
Uncle can say, Neduma Munsu Sara, and you buy a phone as a woman did look right away too many moon.
The form of trading occurs in open market and involves staff having access to huge sums of money running into few millions.
I say, a judge, a jumano, a ya and crofobebre, and yes, the cabbebre, I cabbebre, Abba.
I know how much I pay to security companies to provide the escort for the staff, not to prevent robbery, but to ensure that the staff will go straight to the bank and will not run away with the money. This money spent on security companies is even enough to be declared as profit. He said we have to spend a CCTV, biometric scanners, and other things that wouldn't be needed if the staff weren't looking for opportunity to steal. He said it got so bad at a point that my own criteria for employing a staff was no longer competence or certificate, but honesty.
He said,
at least competence and skills can be learned, but once you are dishonest, you are dishonest. He said, we always complain of the economy and how there are no jobs. I know people abroad who would have loved to set up job creating businesses in Ghana, but they can't because they can't get a trustworthy person to manage the business.
Debi ayaka se aha aya dinsike ni wo ejume ni wo menim krofo bebre a omo wo amanoni a omo person bebie ejuma e wo Ghana ha nanso so mo benya krofo mo de no credit e omo suro.
He said I know people in Ghana with so much money. They want to start factories and other job-creating businesses, but they can't because they are occupied elsewhere and they can't get any trustworthy person to run the business.
He said,
so instead of investing in the real sector and creating jobs, they would rather buy treasury bills and keep their money than opening a business to employ
Ghanaians.
He said, Dangote can open a shop and businesses in every African country in this world. But the problem is that they can't find good people and honest people to manage. He said their biggest problem is top government officials, the dishonesty between government officials that is preventing Africa to become better. He says start a small farm. And they start a small poultry farm and they will steal the eggs. He said if they don't steal the eggs, they will intentionally kill the chicken and the fowls and then they will ask you if they can take it home. Start an entertainment center or a game center and then the money will go into the pockets of the workers. He said the day the sales will go very high, that is when the business owner is there himself. He said they forget that they are eating your money, but they are also eating their future. He said buy a car and let somebody run it as a taxi and then they will finish you. Start a restaurant and the people will take half of the foodstuffs into their house for food. He said even the small business shops, the small kiosks in town would find, people will still find a way to steal from the shop owners.
He said the
worst thing that happens is that they will make this code that the that every person eats from where he works. So they will justify the stealing. He said, I usually say the reason most Ghanaians haven't stolen billions of money is that they haven't gotten the opportunity. How can a businessman say that he managed his company and the Ghanaians he employed were running down the company? And they would rather prefer Indians to manage, be top managers. And these Indians are managing, that they are honest, they are straightforward. The Indians are not Christians. They are Hindus. But most companies in Africa have trusted them because they can run their companies very well. 70% of the population are Christians here in Ghana. 17% or 16% are Muslim. You put that together, over 92% of the people in Ghana are religious. Yet they are thieves, they are robbers, they are damaging the jobs of other people. So you ask yourself the question, what is the use of going to church? What is the use of their being religious? And yet Hindus, who are not Christians, are more straightforward and honest to sustain a business than the people who come to church on a Sunday. We are our own enemies. The businessman said, you wonder why there are no jobs? The people, you meet them on the streets, if they are asking for jobs, you employ them today, tomorrow they will run your company down. You employ members from your church and they will destroy your business for you. We are the Judases betraying one another. We are our own enemies. Look at our traditional leaders and the slave trade. We blame the whites for the slave trade we went through. We blame the whites that they offended us. They took us as slaves. But let's wait for a minute. Who sold the black man to the whites? Who sold the black man to the whites? Our own traditional leaders. The enemy is not outside. The enemy is within. Okukuseku. If we are asking the Europeans, to pacify us and also to apologize to us, our traditional leaders must be the first to apologize on behalf of their ancestors for the evil they have done against their fellow blacks. If you are clapping, clap well. Okukuseku. Why do we blame the whites? We are betraying our own people. Look at our attitude. Number three, our attitude towards the environment and the destruction of our water bodies. Look at the illegal mining, the rivers. The Akobra, the Densu River, all the wonderful rivers we have in our country have turned from blue to gray and now brown and dark brown.
nsuon kitin kitin na ye wo wo kure kure ni mu nyinara no ene ene nyinara aye basa aye fi.
All our river bodies have turned into dabran. And you know what they said? In the next 20 years, if we don't stop this illegal mining, Ghana, we will import water to drink. Yet we don't care. And Chinese, they will come from their country into our forest, destroy our forest, destroy our land, and illegally mine and damage our waters.
Chinese for China for be from Kromaba. No maba be say yen so ni amahuro bebre aye wono.
How can they come if the chiefs did not give them permission? How can they come if the traditional leaders didn't give them permission to do
that?
And in one instance, while they were there, our military went there to protect them. Our own military that is supposed to protect us rather protected the foreigners to destroy our water and destroy our forest. The enemy is not outside. The enemy to our progress is within.
Nemra omo wo ho no asrafo ankese so mo boye ho ban no na omo mu akwa ko bo won ho ban atamfo no eni baby o nemo atamfo no etena ye nche ogina ye ho.
The enemy is not outside, the enemy is within.
Atamfo no oni abonti nemo no owo ye nche obe.
If you look at our own systems and structures in our country, we don't have a better system to improve the lives of people. Pastor, I was surprised when I read in China they had a 10-year vision and they said from 2021, from 2011, their vision was that in 10 years from 2011, and 10 years from 2011 will be what year? This year, 2021, that they will raise over 20% of the people to become multi-millionaires.
Na China for no omo se omo di ifie du esi won enimo se ifie edu echi no omo be pedepeda China for na omo nye obia no aba be simpempem so bi a omo ye odefo.
Now in 2021 they have 1.8 million Chinese who are multi-millionaires in China, and they are between the age of 40 to 50 years. Multi-millionaires. The government intentionally decided that they would make sure they will have 20% of the population multimillionaires. They also agreed that they will make sure that they will lift up the poorest of the poor. And they lifted 100 million people from begging to live a better life. But in this country, in our country, we fight our own businessmen. Our government will fight our business people. When they know that your business is thriving and they know that perhaps you are not sympathetic towards the running party or the ruling party, they will fight you, collapse your company, and make you poor. When in China, they want to make the people rich. In Africa, we want to make our own people poor. The enemy is not outside. The enemy is within.
Atamfo no oni abonti o nemo no atamfo no ewo yemu China no abani bomodin se obe peja peja China fo ni nyinara no ma ba beye odefo na Ghana ha de obi fi ase no ye odefo a yetimi twitwa ne nante esan se e bia na ondo mama anyokuo we anase we ti e be bomodie ne ya sai ne juma no.
Number 5, look at our African leaders. How much they stole, the money they stole away. We are told in Gambia, Jamal Yahaa, he stole $11 million from his own country, Gambia. Sonny Abacha stole between $1 billion to $5 billion out of Nigeria.
Sonny Abacha also Nigeria.
Hosni Burak, Mubarak stole $17 million in 8 years. The enemy is not outside. The enemy to our own progress is within.
Atamfo no oni abonti o atamfo a ope onpese yebetu mpon no obenye owoyemu.
I said the enemy is within. Finally, look at our presidents, the presidents who were fighting for our independence, what we did to them. In Togo, the man who fought for the independence of Togo, called Silvanus Olympio. When Togo got independence, he decided that they would not use the French franc, the French CFA. They decided they will have their own Togo currency. And you know what? They used Iyadema to kill him and to get rid of him. When Olympius wanted to make Togo great, the enemy within, the Judas within, killed him.
Emra Olympio pesan ko bomode na o matogo ye e kuro kese no atamfu a ebenu no eyi ni fi ho.
In Burkina Faso, the man who gave them independence, Maurice Yemegu, was eliminated by his own people.
Na Burkina nso sara mpanyi no ne kurofo ankasa ene yi no.
When Thomas Sankara came, his own body group killed him and got rid of him. The enemy is not outside, the enemy is within.
Na Thomas Sankara nso baye no no ankasa nkurofo na eku no atamfo no eni abonti na emo ebenye.
You look at our own country, Kwame Nkrumah started a new vision to develop Africa, to develop Ghana, and who undermined him from within? They threw him out by Kotoka.
Kwame Nkrumah nso baye no eden na si ye omo tu na de so.
Today we celebrate Kwame Nkrumah, but the own Judas will damage him. I pray that the man who organized that coup to betray Kwame Nkrumah and for us to name our airport after him, Kotoka International Airport, Ghana, we should think twice again.
Berima ah or yes na ye yi Kwame Nkrumah ah enano ye di erimuhyangye bia no atu no no ye mbomode ne adwinhu bio.
I think we should start a national conversation to change the name of the Kotoka International Airport, because as long as that name is, we have endorsed coup, we have endorsed enemies that will fight the progress of our nation. We must change the name of Kotoka International Airport to Kwame Nkrumah International Airport.
Edina diary mu seji na bia no ese ye yikotoka ne fio na de Kwame Nkrumah etu ho.
The enemy is not outside, the enemy is within.
Atamfo no oni abonti na emu no obenye.
He's in our family.
Awo ye busuemu.
He's in our church.
Awo ya safu ni.
The Judas is everywhere.
Judas owo baby biara.
We need to ask God to give us a new character.
Ese ye bisa nyankopo no maye nsuban fufu.
Let's change our behavior and have new values. Because the person will be smiling with you. He's smiling with you, yet he will stab you at the back. The enemy to your progress is not outside, but it's within. How can you have a father who wish you evil? How can you have a father who wants to destroy your life? Yet in Africa, we have governments that do not want to make the people or improve the lives of the people. When in overseas, their governments have created an environment for every citizen to be better. Why is it that our governments can't think about the welfare of the citizens? And we kill the businesses of our own people. May God change our heart. May God change our heart. May God change our heart. The heart of the African, the heart of the Ghanaian is too wicked and evil. And yet we go to church. Yet we sing and dance. And when we get to office on a Monday, we have become Judas. The enemy is not outside. The enemy is within. May God help us and change our hearts. In Jesus Christ's name. Rise on your feet.
Wow. Transformation Hour. It's been another wonderful time of transforming God's people through the word of the Lord. Susan, I don't know, but I think today's message was awesome.
Yes, today's message was indeed powerful, and I believe everyone from all across the world has been blessed by this life-transforming message by our Bishop S.N. Mensah.
It appears we are not the only people blessed by this message. We have a few messages here that we want to share with you to tell you about the wonderful things that God is doing in the life of his people. I have one here from Jafaru Al-Hassan. He says that, I am a Muslim, but I like this great visionary bishop. Sir, you are truly a man of God. May God bless you. Your preaching shows you are a patriotic citizen. I don't know if you have some there.
Yes, I also have one from another Muslim, and he says, thank you, Papa. Honestly, I am a Muslim, but I always have time for your teachings. Mami says also says, your teachings are entirely different from the false messages being preached by the false prophets in Ghana. God bless you, Bishop S.N. Mensah.
Indeed, God bless you. I also have one from me, Ali Manimoda. Says that, Bishop, your great messages must be shared to every living thing. And I think I like this one. It says that, every living thing to hear, they are heavy. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Bishop. Michael Ayepatu also says he was touched after listening to this sermon. He told himself, enough is enough. God bless you, Bishop.
Wes G says that, thank you, sir. You have been a great blessing to my life. I have learned a lot from your teachings. More grace, sir.
More grace, Bishop. Mary Mensah is also wowed by the words and points that are always clear and understanding. She says, more grace, my Bishop. Mercy Mwanzi from Kenya says she is blessed by the teachings from Transformation Hour.
Albert Kujo says, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty for your life and once again for using you to bring this powerful revelation to encouraging people in this end time. More grace.
Evangelist James Labby Lotson also says, I am always blessed when I listen to your messages. God bless you highly, man of God. And Humble Richard says, you are speaking life, and every word that you speak, there is power in it to change life. Thank you, Jesus.
Mili Zubila says, I am always overwhelmed whenever you share the words of wisdom from our great God. God bless you.
God bless you so much, Bishop. We have another one from Emrys D. Atkinson, who says, you won my heart, sir. I love you and your father, Jesus Christ. Indeed, Jesus is the reason for all things, and Transformation Hour still continues to bring you messages that are aimed at ensuring that the word of God and the gospel of the kingdom reaches the ends of the earth. Any more messages?
Sure. Alex Wandi says, powerful words of wisdom. I'm well informed now. God bless you, man of God.
John Say, he says, thanks for the messages. You have now opened my eye well. Indeed, it's an eye-opener. His eyes have been opened well.
Sure. Max Logan says, your teaching motivated, encouraged, and strengthened me whenever I am listening to your preaching. God bless you.
God bless you. And Jebles Nellis from Nigeria is always blessed to listen to Transformation Hour messages. He says, I always love listening to your messages.
Nene Joe Dometo says, you are always encouraging us and teaching us reality in life. I really appreciate your teaching. God bless you, Bishop. We'll visit your temple one of these days. And we are always open to welcome guests to visit with us. Let me seize this opportunity to also encourage you, if you are anywhere and you want to fellowship, all our churches are open. Our pastors are waiting with open arms to give you a warm reception to fellowship with them. We have branches across the length and breadth of this country. We also have branches overseas. If you peradventure find yourself in a place where there is no full gospel church, you can join a Bible-believing church and make sure that your life is transformed, as we all expect to be in heaven.
We have another message from Nairobi, Kenya, from Eriki Lex Voldemort. And he says, I watch your sermons from Nairobi, Kenya, and I really love them. You are truly a blessing to many that you don't know.
Sure. Ruby Believe says, I am really touched by this preaching. Thank you so much, man of God.
Dope Boy Daisy Rude says, Bishop Samuel N. Mensah, you always inspire me. God
sure,
bless
sure.
you.
He always inspires. Samuel John, anytime I listen to your preaching, I'm always a different person. And that is an evidence of transformation right there for you. You have more.
Yes, there are lots of messages here. I'll take one from It's Bankole Smart. He's also from Nigeria, and he says, I like listening to your message. May God continue to bless you.
Zainab Ibrahim says, thank you, Daddy, for these words. It had really touched my heart. May the Lord Almighty bless you abundantly.
We'll end with another message from Nigeria from Tochukwu John, who says, he is from Nigeria, but he always loves listening to these messages. God bless you all so much for sharing with us your messages and for also encouraging everyone to continue listening to Transformation Hour.
You can also send in your message and it will be read live here during Transformation Hour. We receive these things and we read them so that others will be encouraged. Because there may be somebody sitting somewhere going through a challenging time, but your message of encouragement will quicken that person's spirit. So we encourage you, stay tuned to Transformation Hour, watch and share your experiences with us, and we believe that it will be a blessing to someone else. Just as I said before, if you find yourself anywhere, please look for a Full Gospel church near you and fellowship with us. You can also call any of the contacts that have been shared there, and then our pastors are waiting to pray with you. If you call and the line is engaged, please don't despair. Don't give up. Keep calling, and our pastors will pray with you. And we believe, trusting God, that our lives will indeed be transformed. Susan, do you have any message for us?
Yes. Once again, we are encouraged to follow the bishop on all of his social media handles, on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, and on YouTube. All you have to do is to just search Bishop Samuel N. Mensah, and you get to listen and see more life-transforming messages.
More life-transforming messages. We also want to encourage you. You know, these things involves money. So if you want to help us push this gospel, you can pick any of the Momo numbers that we've shared on the screen. We've also shared our bank details. You can just drop in a seed to push this gospel. If you are also an institution who wants to partner with us to ensure this gospel reaches the unreached, we are always welcome. We will give you the opportunity to sow. And we believe that as we are sowing and lives are being transformed, your business will also be transformed. Please, no amount is too small. Just make sure you share it with us. And we believe that the word of the Lord will travel the length and breadth of the world, and other lives will also be blessed. God bless you so much for making time to watch Transformation Hour this day. We hope to meet some other time during Transformation Hour. But for now, we leave you with the peace of the Lord, and we say bye-bye.
Bye. God bless you.
It's a small group. Are you a pastor with a small group ministry in a church? Are you looking for ways to make your small groups effective that will lead to church growth? Are you struggling with how to start a small group in your church? Then look no further. Grab a copy of Small Groups Manual by Bishop S.N. Mensah for practical steps in starting small groups and identifying the roles of both leaders and members in keeping a healthy small group. Remember, in the midst of a pandemic where large gatherings are not permitted, the only effective means to keep in touch with your congregation is through the small groups. The small groups are met in homes in the books of Acts were a strategic part of the greater church and hence remains an indispensable element of church management. For copies of this book, contact the following numbers: 0243-277-084 or 054-2599-834. Remember, a pastor without a small group is a pastor without a church.
Thank you for watching, and we hope you've been blessed. We invite you to join us this and every Sunday for our friendly service at the Full Gospel Church International, Community One, behind Ogbonu FM Tema, or at any of our branches across the country. For more inquiries, prayers and counseling, contact us on the following numbers: 0242-774-308, 0244-973-326, 0244-489-046, 0243-858-207, or 0542-599-834. Visit our website at www.fullgospelghana.org or send us an email at info@fullgospelghana.org. You can write personally to Bishop S.N. Mensah at Bishop Mensah at fullgospelghana.org. Full Gospel Church International, transforming lives on purpose.